Hello, Scorpio. This is a surprise mid-month reading. I'm going to do a full reading for you for mid-month November 2020. So this is general. This is for anyone with prominent Scorpionic placement in your chart. There will not be an extended. I'm going for it. So by now you know how long this will be, but I want to be thorough. So I just asked Spirit, you know, I'd like to begin doing a mid-month for those who are in their birthday season. And I just felt like it was kind of important to do one for Scorpio for whatever reason. There's been a huge shift in the energies. I'm feeling it. My clients are feeling it. There's something big going on. So we're going to get to it. So first, what I channeled from Spirit, I heard, I'm rearranging my life. That's kind of big, kind of deep. It feels heavy yet exhilarating for some reason. I'm getting a sense of both. It's almost like there's a sense of needing to take care of some things. In fact, the visual they gave me, first they said, my needs need to be met, but I'm sandwiching them in between obligations, and they showed me literally a sandwich. I'm not hungry, I promise. This is really, you know, everything stuffed between obligation one and obligation two is what you want. But it's almost like, I don't know, maybe there's a stuckness or there's something that you need to do first. It was a kind of an interesting analogy. You are hungering for something. You're coming back to life. I found that really interesting. It's almost as if your eyes have been opened to something, Scorpio, and you're handling the task at hand, if you will. There's something that you're having to do, but the pieces and parts of your life, I feel you're kind of, you're moving them around so that you can align something. That's kind of what I'm getting with this. So this will be interesting. Let's see what we have. A lot flew out. We have 7 spiritual journey oracles for you. So let's see what we have for you, Scorpio, mid-month. Wow, karmic lessons. I won't read the caption. You're going through a tough time, or you're coming out of a tough time. Yeah, trauma and wounds. So I feel like you're letting some things go. I'm picking up on the word here, familial. This could be related to family trauma, family patterns and challenges. And I feel like, hence the obligation. So, you know, this sandwich is, you know, or maybe you're the bread and everything in the middle is obligation. I don't know. However that applies to you, if that applies to you, I feel like there's some things you need to take care of in your life. And I am picking up now a really strong familial vibe. Your higher self. Wow. This could be, you know, around ascension, an awakening. Something about a higher purpose is coming through for me. Coming out of a challenging place and stepping into who you're meant to be, what you're meant to do. Oh my gosh. Wow. Healer. You're gifted with the ability to heal. Oh my gosh. Or you could be connected to someone who has healed you. Maybe you're in a very healing connection. Journey to fulfillment. This is about taking charge of your destiny. And there's your card. I don't apply these to signs necessarily, but Scorpio is all about transitioning, transformation. So you are shedding layers of yourself. Things are changing for you. Wow. I almost feel like you're at, you know, sort of that proverbial crossroads, but you've felt like it's necessary. There's something you have experienced that has kind of prompted this sort of change, and you're kind of tying up loose ends. You're ready and hungry for something else. Guidance from Spirit. Wow. Yeah. If this is hard for you, if there is a breaking away from something, a sunsetting, something that's really tugging at you, I do feel like, you know, your guide, Spirit, they're there for you. They're there to help you and guide you through it. Oh my goodness. Wow. I didn't mean for this to be a heavy reading, but I just asked Spirit, what needs to come through. So here we go. Let's take a look at what is going on for you. Let's pick up some energies in your life and around you at this time. What can you tell us, Spirit? That wants to come through. Okay. What else? Wow. All right, let's see what we have here. Oh my goodness. This is interesting. Okay. We have a consciousness of lack. Interesting energy. I am getting that some of you, I just saw 555, some of you may be changing careers. Some of you may be working through a financial situation, perhaps, that's been draining. Maybe you even have, a family situation that's really, pulling on your pocketbook. There's an interesting energy with this. It's also that there is somewhat of a void to be filled. And, it could be around money. I'm always drawn to the heart, drawn around this window that has coins in it. There's something here that has impacted your emotional health. Something void I'm picking up. Okay, we have discovery. In the realm of intention, I feel like you might be looking at your life. You might be looking at your circumstances, the people around you, maybe what you've obligated yourself to in your life. Maybe you've done a lot. Maybe you're considering retirement. You're wondering if you're going to have enough money to stretch. Great achievement. You've done good things, or you are hoping to achieve something. Interesting. Optimism. I love that. Positivity. Even through some of the difficulty that you've been through, you're holding your head high. You're optimistic about starting a new journey, walking a new path, what tomorrow holds. It's like, this whole I'm rearranging my life is coming through here. It feels like you've done this and it's great, and maybe that's gotten you just so far, and you realize that, well, if I want to be really happy, I have to go get this. I have to do this. Maybe it's in the realm of, your emotions, or if you're not resonating with being the loving woman, this could be someone in your life. Commitment. Wow. Are you working through some obligations? Are you working through some work obligations, perhaps, or building some wealth, maybe, to offer a commitment to someone? Of course this comes back to love, right? Oh my gosh. Okay, let's see. I went a little backwards. I jumped right into that deck, but let's get some overarching energy in this situation, because it sounds like you know what you want, Scorpio. You know what you want. You are working through a perhaps difficult past, or have connected with someone who is, but I'm going to speak as though this is you. Swap it if it makes sense, but I feel like you're really realizing what you want, maybe trying to figure out how to get it, but you're looking at your life more deeply and realizing that if you want to be happy in some regard, if you want to be fulfilled, if there's a void in your life, it's up to you to go get it. It's up to you to go get it, and Spirit is guiding you on that journey. So let's see what the energies are in this situation. Energies surrounding this situation, please, Spirit. Oh my gosh. I'll take them. Oh, and then there's that. Wow, guys. Higher power. My goodness, your higher self. I'm looking at this loyal heart that came out. You may be in a very spiritual connection, high vibration love. This could be someone who has, you know, awakened something in you. Unbelievable. Oh, am I getting a repeat message here? Okay, we have the tribe. You could be connecting with someone in your soul tribe, a very strong soulmate. This can also be the energy, actually I'll put them up here. This can be the energy of family. I was picking up familial from this trauma and wounds card. Exchanging gifts. This is what we give. This is what we get back. It's all about reciprocity in relationships. Reciprocity in our lives. Are we giving to something and are we fulfilled by that? And it's not always about what we get. That's not what it's about. But deep down, you know, we have to know that happiness and fulfillment begins with us. It has to. Truth be told. Conversations. Truth being revealed. Truth being shared. Or someone is sharing it with you. We have orphaned. I always look at this as an exit. Those of you who follow me know that somebody is leaving something behind, and it can be just trauma of the past. There's a disconnecting of anything that makes us feel sad, lonely, out on our own, unable to relate to other people, without, in some regard, lacking something. And I feel like this is the beginning of the journey, right? A change in the wind. Something is shifting. You know, for some of you, this is relationship, clearly. For others of you, this is lessons that you've had to learn, and that lesson is being cemented now. It's also a continuation with someone. Something's not done. New life. I would say that's pretty transformative. Okay, so some of you are moving into a connection with someone after leaving something else behind. I'm not going to be able to make room for all these, so we'll just do that. Holy cow, lots of messages, but I feel like it's a pretty strong theme coming through. So let's take a look at your energy, Scorpio. How are you faring during this period of time? Because I feel like while you're rearranging your life and you figure out what obligations you need to fulfill so that you can move on to your own happiness, your own fulfillment, likely in love or in relationship with someone, there's a lot to do. So let's see what's going on with you. Energy around Scorpio, mid-month November spirit. Energy around Scorpio, mid-month. I'll get that one off the floor. Energy around Scorpio, please. Oh my gosh. Okay. So, let me grab this from the floor. The Wheel of Fortune. Cycles changing. It can be the karmic wheel moving forward. Oh my gosh. Okay, we have heart chakra. Wow, guys, I feel as though there's deep emotion. In one regard, it's emotion around what you've experienced. In another, it is emotion you feel for someone. If this is related to what you're lacking, maybe this has been a long journey for you to come back to what fulfills you. Wow. Wisdom. Whenever I see the Hierophant, I think of tradition, learned knowledge, family experience. Yeah, there's something coming through with family again for some reason, a very strong energy around that. Past experience that has been perhaps difficult, lessons learned. I'm getting... Not only is this tower, this disruption energy about a huge change in your life, I feel like it's an epiphany of some sort, but things are going to look very different. You're really moving through massive change. The Lovers. I love that. Oh my gosh. Very connected to another person, very connected. What I'm getting, I know these cards come out independently, but I'm looking at the two together, and what spirit is giving me is that this is almost something you've never experienced before. It is going to change your life. It changes your viewpoint about love, about what you knew traditionally to be true about love, what your family's taught you about love. Oh my goodness. Prosperity begins. Sometimes with the wheel and the Ace of Pentacles, which is this energy, I do get that there is something around your money, your stability, that is coming into view here. So this could be about work, a change in the type of work you do. But I do feel like whatever is being planned here, this is like a journey to your higher self. This is such strong energy and transformative love. Transformative love. This is going to be a very life-altering commitment. Oh my, wow. Okay, so let me put these over here, get them out of the way and make some room. Okay, let's see what we've got for you, Scorpio. So let's take a look at, oh, could be regarding career. For some of you, clearly this is a pretty specific message for someone who's going to go through a massive change in their life. Perhaps around work, perhaps it's because of a love connection. So let's take a look at what's on the horizon for you, mid-month November, Scorpio. What do you have, Spirit? What is on Scorpio's path? Let's look at how these energies will unfold for them. Oh boy. Oh boy. All right, Spirit. What's going to unfold for Scorpio, please? I know there's more in there. I feel the energy. Okay. They're flying. Okay, wow. To me, this is all about lessons, wounding, and releasing pain of the past, experiences of the past. You know, I, as a person, as a reader, it's difficult to always find kind of that hidden pearl in what we go through, but it sure makes our path easier if we can recognize it. Understand what it taught us, lovingly release things that need to be released, and that'll mean different things for different people. But you know, karma and lessons can be what we make them. I mean, you know, really, it's all about our life path, what shapes us, what has gotten us to this point. And there we have the card of karma. Does not surprise me that that's here. Forgiveness. Forgiveness for ourselves, other people. Perhaps this is, you know, something regarding this connection. Maybe there's been a disruption in this connection, a difficult lesson learned. This can be a connection maybe that's being left behind. Again, that could be family, it could be a relationship. Storm brewing. Something's about to be upended. We have children. This can be related to childhood. Children may be in your life impacted somehow. This can speak to, you know, a youthful sort of energy. There's a lot of ways that I can read this card. This can be childhood wounding. That back to that familial thing. So it will differ for everybody, but interesting that came through when we had the familial kind of energy around trauma. Intimacy. Meeting someone new. So I feel like there is a connection that will deepen. there is a connection that perhaps is going under some sort of metamorphosis and change. At least your life is, I feel. Something big is going to be just totally shifted. I mean, my gosh, look at this. Change in the wind, new life, loyal heart. Very interesting. So let's take a look at who you're connected with. Tell us about Scorpio's person. Who is Scorpio connected to, Spirit? Tell us about their energy. Anything else? I just saw the Four of Wands trying to make an appearance. Okay, anything else? Scorpio's person. Bottom of the deck, we have Queen of Swords. You could be connected to an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. That could also be your person having a lot of, yes, clarity. Clarity. Ace of Swords, Three of Wands. Clear about the future. Letting go of hurt from the past. Wow. So this energy could be your person. Oh my goodness. The Emperor. Taking charge, taking control. Divine masculine energy. Wow. Coming into their heart space. King of Cups. Judgment. This is big. I feel like there's a realization going on in your connection that there's an awareness of your connection. There's an awareness of needing to move on from the past, let go of hurt. Again, this could have happened between the two of you or just in life in general. Wow. Okay, so let's take a look at some of this energy. Tell us about this truth and clarity. Ace of Swords. Five of Pentacles. There is potentially a consciousness of lack with this energy. Walking away from something. There's a departure. This is moving on. It could be, related to work, but it could be a feeling of having to let go of something that maybe once felt secure, and now there's clarity around, okay, fine, maybe I had security, maybe it was around work, but I wasn't happy. Something was left void. There'll be messages. Messages of love, an indicator that, you know, something is shifting and changing. Tell us about the message, Spirit. Page of Cups. Hanged Man. I have a new perspective on this. I've been thinking a lot about my situation. I don't like where I am emotionally. I'm ready to make change. Bottom of the deck, Three of Cups. Coming together, celebrating, reunions. Let's look at this Emperor energy. Tell us about the Emperor spirit. Nine of Pentacles, Magician. If this has been something that your person has been trying to manifest, something that creates financial stability that could be coming through, they may be a little bit, focused on their foundation, doing well, being able to move out on their own. I say that we have Justice at the bottom of the deck. Maybe bringing finances into balance. And then we have the heart space. Let's take a look at the King of Cups. Wow. Four of Swords, bottom of the deck, Hermit, Virgo energy. This could be taking time out to really come to terms with their feelings, maybe not fully expressing them, but really thinking about and healing their heart. Remember, we have heart space here. So let's take a look at judgment. Judgment day, what decision will be made? Judgment, please. Okay, two cards flipped up in the deck. One on the, the one on the floor is justice. So bringing some balance back into their life, into your connection. Oh my goodness. Temperance, the Ace of Wands, the Empress. Oh my goodness. So we have divine feminine energy here. This now your person could be embodying this very, you know, abundant and fertile energy. This can also be that your person is wanting to come back in and balance your connection, heal your connection, express passion. There is this realization, I feel, that you get one shot at this. I mean, if I were to sum it up as a reader intuitively, I've got one shot at this. I've got this certain someone right in front of me, this loyal heart, this beautiful, passionate connection right in front of me that is life-changing. Am I going to focus on, you know, my work and not that, you know, life has to be a grind. I mean, we all live, we have to do this. But it's almost as if there's a shift in consciousness to really, you know, to this. What makes me happy? All right, let's take a look at what other thoughts and feelings are going on inside of your person, Scorpio. Tell us about Scorpio's person. Okay, just one card. We have culmination of vision, planning coming to fruition, cycles ending. This could have been a connection that has maybe been morphing and transitioning over time, you know, because of family obligations, things that needed to be worked out, people who needed attention, and it could definitely be about children and family. I mean, we have that here. So, how's your person feeling? This is the Whispers of Love deck. How is your person feeling about this connection, Scorpio? Wow. Oh my gosh. So remember the sandwich? I'm sandwiching my needs in between obligations or whatever. We have rest and relaxation is essential. We all have a fundamental need to take a break. Your person might be working really hard to make something happen. It could literally be at a new job, at work, trying to, you know, build their wealth and their stability, right? And then we have back to what you love. Reevaluate your desires. Wow. Wow. I'm getting a strong Hierophant energy here. And the knowledge that, you know, like where you put your energy, what does it give back to you? What is it all for? Interestingly, at the bottom of the deck, which I now can relate to what we just saw, the Five of Swords. Now I'm going to get what I want. And it may leave others, you know, head hung low, walking away, but I'm going to get what I want. I'm getting a positive, selfish energy with this. Like, it's okay, Scorpio, for you to achieve something for yourself. Bottom of the deck, have faith. Trust your faith in this situation. Something is unfolding for you that, I don't know, do you see this coming? I think you do. I think you do. I think that you have perhaps been kind of, maybe this is your energy, feeling that you've been a little disconnected from your person, wanting to know, hey, what are you doing? Tell me what you're up to. What can I do for you? Maybe just holding out, holding back, and being hopeful while there's this epiphany, this realization, wow, this is right in front of me. I could have this. I see it now. I see it now. Okay, so let's look at what's going on in your relationship dynamic. Scorpio and their person. Spirit, what can you tell us about the dynamic in this connection, this very deep, loyal soulmate connection? Dynamic between Scorpio and their love interest, please. What is the dynamic in this connection? Anything else? Ooh, on my lap. Okay. Bottom of the deck, power and control. We grasp tightly when we feel we're losing control or fear failure. Let things unfold as they will. It's part of the journey. All right, so let's see what we've got here. For some of you, this may be an energy also related to relationships with family members that can come through here. All right, we have directness. There's a need for clear, concise communication, which will eliminate ambiguity. Yeah, Ace of Swords. Suppression. What must be dealt with can no longer be ignored. Self-respect. We must first honor ourselves. Focus. External stimulus can block progress, limit distractions that are not helping you. For some of you, that's a family vibe. It's a work vibe. Conserve resources. That's that consciousness of lack energy again. Pay attention to where your time and money are spent. And insensitivity. Whether through a lack of understanding or selfishness, there's a need to value each other's feelings. Yeah, that can apply to many relationships, honestly, but very interesting energies. Okay, so let's take a look at what shifts and changes have occurred with your person. Shifts and changes with Scorpio's love interest. Wow, my goodness. What else? I feel one more in there. What else, Spirit? Yep, bottom of the deck, self-employment. Interesting. There may be that new opportunity coming to them. These cards are all about doing what speaks to their heart. Realizations and epiphanies. Religion and spirituality. Beliefs. I'm getting heavy beliefs with this. Experience. Conviction, gracefully aging. What do I want my life to look like, right? Volunteer. On their own, they're making choices. So it feels like this energy here of moving through massive change sounds like your person. It can be vice versa, but wow. Big, big aha moments coming to your person. So let's look at the lessons. What has healed in this connection or must heal in this connection? You'll all be in a little bit of different place. What can you tell us about the lessons learned in this dynamic, Spirit? Something in there, I feel it. Lessons that have been learned, Spirit. Or must be learned. Wow. Anything else? Wow, this card I'm looking at really resonates with this reading. Look at that, happiness. I'm aware that being happy means I'm on the right path. I look at this as if I want to be happy, if I want joy in my life, I've got to make some decisions about what's important to me. Honesty, I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it from myself. And judgment, I understand that everyone has their own unique path and challenges. So, you know, there is a strong need to understand what drives the other person, for both of you, really. The choices we make in life are based a lot of times on our beliefs, on what we think we should do, on the obligations we create for ourselves, family. And, you know, sometimes decisions we make, we feel they're the right ones at the time, maybe not. Whatever has happened, I do feel that there is the need to just be super honest and upfront about exactly what you want. If it's not, you know, apologies for wrongdoing, because we do have forgiveness here, I'm feeling more so it's about speaking your truth. Absolute truth. Okay, so let's look at the future of this connection. Scorpio and their person, future energies, please. Get to the heart of the matter. What else? Wow. Okay, we have a couple things here. Reconciling. So for some of you, this is making amends. This is a relationship that has the strength to come back together, to be, you know, balanced. For others, I'm seeing these energies want to pop out. We have shutting you out and rejection. So I feel a mixed bag of energies here. There may be a family situation that will be left behind, or a person left behind, orphaned, right? And for others of you, there is a connection that awaits, something that will definitely be life-altering. Okay, let's get a romance angel for you. Okay, wow, guys. We have deception. Unrequited love. Let go of control issues. Yikes. It feels like there's something going on that hasn't been voiced. There's a truth that needs to be told, something that needs to be shared. And it could be that there's an expression of, you know, where I am, I'm not happy, I don't want to stay. For others of you, you might have felt that this was something that was never going to come back together. But there's a huge, I mean, we have judgment under here. There's a decision that's about to be made. And I feel like something is going to have an opportunity to blossom. All right, let's see. Anything else? This could be the one. Peeking out, getting to know each other, chemistry. So this could be this new love. So, you know, this is going to differ for all of you. Some of you may be in a situation, a family situation that is tough, and you're walking away from it to have a new life, a new beginning with someone. Some of you may know this person, some of you may not. So very interesting. All right, let's finish up with some advice. Stay in a positive vibration. You will bring more of the same to your life. Let go and allow spirit to take the lead. This is in the hands of the divine. So I do feel like whatever change someone is stepping into, it is being divinely guided. This is, it's big change. It's intended to bring change into someone's life. It's time to turn the wheel forward. It's time to move into something new. Anything you can tell Scorpio about this situation? Any other advice and guidance? Try that again. Anything else? Okay, that one hit me right in the face. I'm resilient. I can take it. Oh, we even have a timing card. Okay, let's get this one off the floor. Confidence. Very confident. Flew that way. Compliment each other. Healing wounds. Blossoming love. Wanting a break. Yes, I feel for those of you who resonate with, you know, dealing with your obligations and then exiting, this could be your energy within 3 months. Let's find out what that's about. Clarify within 3 months, please. Tell us about that, Spirit. What will happen within 3 months? Within 3 months, what's that about? Get one more. Okay. Wow. Kind of cryptic. We have the Two of Pentacles. So if this is the rearranging that your person is doing or you're doing, apply it where it makes sense. There's a lot of work being done to achieve something. Knight of Swords. Coming in fast. Also delivering news. Tell us about that. Oh, King of Wands, courage, passion, strength, and the world. Wrapping up a cycle. It could be, you know, for some of you, there might be travel involved here. Wow. Anything else Scorpio needs to know? The Fool, a brand new beginning. Yep, brand new beginning. New life. Where is that? Yep. Big change. Transformative change. New love. Okay, Scorpio. I'm going to leave it there. Have a great rest of the month, and I will see you in December. Take care.